on autopsy, and that's of players who've been studied who've had brain injury. So you take a lot of football players study who have brain evidence of brain injury, they die, you study the brains, and lo and behold, their brain shows evidence of brain injury. Again, not a surprise. But they also looked at some high school, college, semi-pro players, Canadian Football League players, and theirs showed some degree of brain injury as well. The more years playing football, it appears, the greater the risk of having CTE. But we're still not sure what that truly means. And the reason for that is we don't have a comparison group. What about all the football players who die a nice, long, lengthy life and don't have any evidence of brain injury? Do they have CTE or not? We haven't studied their brains. And so we do know that hits to the head aren't a good thing for us. We know that it can cause injury, it can cause mood disorder, it can cause Alzheimer's-like symptoms, early dementia, but we don't know the full story about what the significance of these CTE findings is.
It's definitely an interesting study, and I'd like to see what comes from it, or what other studies they could look into. I'd be interested to see if they just took 100 of anyone's brains and took a real look at them to see if they had CTE. That's kind of my take on it, but you don't really know, so this is kind of just the beginning of it, and we'll kind of see how it develops. Yeah, I'm sure, this is just the beginning. I mean, there'll be more studies and stuff to come out, so I'm just as interested as everyone else to kind of see what happens.